So let us, we are looking at the example in the last lecture related to where a billiards ball is impacted by a force that sets the ball in motion, okay. So now let us look at an example problem where a ball has been set into motion, there are no forces acting on the ball except the natural forces due to friction between a table and the billiard ball. Okay, now we are asked to analyze the motion of this subsequent to the disappearance of the cue stick originated force. Okay. So let us look at this example problem and see what we can make of this. Again we have in this case a circular cylinder that is starting at this point A at some time instant 0. The linear velocity of this hoop of this circular cylinder was 16 meters per second and the angular velocity is 0. And we are asked to find the time instant at which slipping would stop. So we have to find the time instant at which the hoop would quit slipping. Now initially the hoop was here and initially the hoop is only translating, there is no rotational motion, but over some period of time there is friction force that is acting at this point of contact, I will call this B, and the friction force at this point of contact B is going to initiate angular motion of this circular cylinder, where by some other distance C, by the time the cylinder reaches another distance C, the system would have reached no slip rolling condition. So let us try to identify this condition. So we start again just by looking at this initial condition that Vi is 16 meters per second and omega is 0 implies it is slipping. So it is in a pure sliding motion. Okay, so now let us draw a free body diagram of this circular cylinder. There is the weight that is countered by the normal reaction from the table. The only other force acting is a friction force F, and because we know the velocity is to the right, at this point of contact, if I now mark two points, I will try to zoom in here. And draw a magnified picture between the table and the cylinder. The cylinder surface is moving to the right and the table is at rest. Therefore, friction, like we said earlier, always acts to oppose relative motion, therefore, it acts from right to left. Not just that, we know that this would have to equal F max because there is relative motion, friction acts in its fullest strength to cause relative motion to cease. And in this particular problem, F max equals mu times n, which mu we are told is half. And n would simply equal W. If I take on which is 64 newtons. So the maximum possible friction force is 32 newtons. And the force that acts at this point of contact will be equal to 32 newtons because the hoop as a whole is slipping at that time instant 0. Now as this friction force acts, the cylinder begins to develop an angular velocity. So let us now do will apply our Euler's laws of motion and get the angular as well as linear acceleration. So, I am going to replace. So, if alpha is the angular acceleration and a is the linear acceleration of this hoop, what I do know is that minus f max equals mass times acceleration, which implies minus 32 equals 64 divided by 10 times the acceleration, which implies the acceleration is minus 5 meters per second squared. Okay. I chose the acceleration to point to my right, but the value came out to be minus 5, that means the cylinder is actually decelerating. Remember, the velocity is plus 16 to start with. So, the velocity is plus 16 to the right and the acceleration is to the left, which means it is going to be decelerating. So, let us now also do the moment balance. Again, I will choose to do this about the cylinder center of mass. The only force that causes a moment is the same F max, nothing else. So, F max times the radius equals m r squared over 2 times alpha. F max is 32 times the radius we are told is 2 meters. That means alpha is 5 radians per second squared. So, now let us understand what is happening here at this point A. Let us understand the kinematics of this cylinder. At this point A, the velocity equals 16 meters per second. And the angular velocity omega is 0. These are the initial conditions at t I equals 0. At some other instant t, let us say omega is the angular velocity and v is the final velocity. How do I know that the cylinder is rolling without slip? So, these are all in the same surface. Cylinder achieves no slip. When v equals r omega. Okay. So, until at this point of contact, you know, we did that until the point of contact, c is no relative motion, the friction force will continue to act. Okay. So, if I write what is v of t, v of t minus v at the instant 0 equals 0 to t a dt. We calculated the linear acceleration to be minus 5 meters per second squared, which implies v at any instant t minus 16. 0 to t 5 with a negative sign dt, which also implies that v of t is 16 minus 5 t, and this has units of meter per second. Similarly, if I do the angular velocity calculation, omega of t minus omega of 0 equals 0 to t alpha dt, which implies omega of t minus 0 equals plus 5, because the angular acceleration is plus 5 radians per second squared dt, which also implies omega of t equals 5 t radian per second. Now, for no slip, we said at the instant when V of t, I will call this V s of t equals r times omega, or when V of t becomes r times omega of t, slip would have completely ceased. Okay, so let us take 16 minus 5 t equals 2 times 5 t. Which implies 16 equals 15 t, which also implies t equals 16 over 15 seconds. So, until this time instant, the hoop would be slipping at the point of contact. So, if what would be interesting is to draw the friction force as a function of time. So, F max is 32 newtons. So, F max would be constant till this time instant 16 over 15 seconds, and at that point in time the friction force would instantaneously become 0. This is our model of Coulomb friction. What is interesting is that as you approach the point where slip is beginning to go to 0, the friction would persist as long as there is some sliding motion between the surfaces. The instantaneous sliding ceases simultaneously with the friction going to 0. And as soon as the friction disappears, this body now has a velocity that is given by, so V of t at this time instant is given by 16 minus 5 into 16 over 15 that is 32 over 3 meters per second, and the angular velocity would be 16 over 3 meters per second. So, the angular velocity and the linear velocity from this point forward are fully conserved, that is they will not change in magnitude because no other force would continue to act on this system. The only force that was acting to bring slip at the point of contact to 0 was friction, and the moment its job is done, the moment the friction force becomes, the moment relative motion ceases, friction force also becomes 0, and naturally the body continues to remain in a state of uniform motion as Newton's first law would tell us. Okay, that brings us to the end of this week's lectures. We will continue our discussion of work energy relationships and some problems on vibrations in the next week.